Hey there everyone, Dr. Beth Westie here, and I wanted to talk about having bad PMS, what this means, and some really key things on why you might be having bad PMS. Now the first one that I listed, you might think, duh! Of course there's a hormonal imbalance, that's why my hormones are up and I have scalp premenstrual syndrome for a reason! Yeah! I'm going to dive into that in just a minute, but I do talk about taking the Dutch test. So Dutch test, this is a sample of a Dutch test that we would get looking at your hormones, not just what your levels are, but how your body's processing your hormones. Really key and important to understanding why you're having the symptoms you're having at the time of month that you are having them. Right? So I'm going to put a link here in the comments for you to get your very own Dutch test. You order the test, it gets sent right to your house. Then you take the test, send it into the lab, and then once the results are in, we go over your test. You get to learn what your levels are, what your system's having an issue with, and then steps to take. I give you steps to take as well. It's not just like, oh, here it is, see you later. That's tough. It's here's what you can do about it. Here's some things to move forward with. So when we look at hormonal imbalance related to PMS, a lot of times this can be connected with having estrogen levels that are higher than your progesterone levels. It's important that they are correlated with each other. Otherwise, it's going to throw things off. It's also important that your testosterone androgen levels are even. And it's important we look at cortisol, because even if your estrogen and progesterone levels are, oh, look, they're balanced, they look good, but your cortisol is terrible. When your hormones shift, the fact that your body has a negative cortisol response means that your system is gonna have that much harder of a time when your hormones shift over. So it feels like you got hit by a hormone truck. Just, I feel so awful. Ugh. And then if anything extra stressful happens that day, you're done, you're toast. Yeah, so that's why it's important that we do Dutch tests, that we take a look at what your hormones are doing, and then steps to take to help your body function better, to correct that hormonal imbalance. So that's one of the big things with PMS. Nutrient deficiency. Nutrient deficiency is a big one. A lot of times people don't realize, like, you actually need more nutrients leading up to when your cycle starts. You need more protein, more healthy fats, more minerals, more calorie per day. So the fact that you're getting cravings and everything else and you're like, oh, I shouldn't eat. I don't want to eat this. I ate too much last week at the holiday. Oh, I can't eat anymore. No, that's going to be bad. It's going to be bad. It's going to be terrible for your system if it doesn't get the nutrients it needs. Then you're going to notice that you don't feel good. If you are nutrient depleted, you know, you can't fix that by like running on a treadmill harder, right? Or just trying to squash those cravings that you have. You have those cravings for a reason. Listen to your body and what it needs by getting the right nutrients in at the right time of the month. And again, these are things that I can teach you when we work together, but also just getting your Dutch test is helpful. Why would that be helpful for nutrient deficiencies? Oh, because they test nutrients right here. Nutrient panels, this is a great way to know if your nutrients are off. Yeah. Yep. Great way to know if your nutrients are off. Last one here is that your digestive system slows down. This can create a lot of PMS. This, when your digestive system slows down, it creates a lot more bloating. You're going to have more nutrient deficiency because your gut's not going to be absorbing enough of the right nutrients at this time, even if you're eating it. And then it contributes to more hormonal imbalance because it doesn't help your body process the hormones either. That's not great. No. So adding some apple cider vinegar in, there's an apple cider vinegar drink that I talk about that's really helpful for boosting your gut movement there. And then your body can move things along like they should. When your gut feels better, you feel better, and that can lighten up on a lot of PMS symptoms and issues. So that's what I got for you guys today. Let me know if you have any other questions. Again, getting Dutch test. If you want your own Dutch test, see what your hormones are, go in the comments, click that link. Other resources I have for you are my books, The Female Fat Solution, The Female Menopause Solution. These are on Amazon. Lots of great resources on how to eat for your hormones and your cycle. I also have my podcast, The Female Health Solution, and my YouTube channel, Dr. Beth Westie, which you can subscribe to stay updated on all the things I have coming out. And then I also have my tinctures for your hormones and cycle. These are fantastic for helping your body balance estrogens, balance progesterones, taking them throughout the month to also even out PMS. So let me know if you guys have any other questions or need anything else. Otherwise, I will see you later.